Hello everyone, and happy Manga Monday to you. It is the first Monday of a new month, if you can believe it. And so I'm going to be sharing my May monthly haul wrap-up video with you all, talking about the books I got in May. And if you're new here, hi, hello, welcome, welcome, come in, sit down, hopefully you enjoy the video. My name is Zoe and this is my channel, Ms. Manga, where I talk a lot about manga. And yeah, that's the video today, so let's get into it. Alrighty, I'm just gonna start with the manga that I've already made two videos on, so if you haven't watched those, go check them out. But my friend Devin was so kind as to send me some birthday manga surprise first volumes off of my Amazon wish list, and these are those. I'll just share them real quick. We have Delicious in Dungeon, Tomb Raider King, Wolf and Parchment, Go Go Loser Ranger, The Girl I Like Forgot Her Glasses, I'm Quitting Heroing, and Doomsday with My Dog. So if you want to see my reaction and impressions on those first volumes, then go check this video out. I had a ton of fun reading them, and thanks again, Devin. I also had another friend of mine gift me this series. It is the Midnight Secretary series, and yeah, I'm really interested to read it. It's a bit more of a smutty shoujo read. I have deduced, and so I don't know, it could be fun. I mean, she said she enjoyed the read, but wouldn't probably read it again, so she was getting rid of it, and I was interested, so she gifted them to me. Thanks a lot. I'm super excited to read it. Next up, we have the birthday manga presents my lovely parents gave me. Thanks if you're watching. And first up, we have the Seven Seas. Oh god. First up, we have the Seven Deadly Sins box set, and this is the first box set. I was really excited because I want to read more of this series, and then I'm like, what the heck is with that? It's a present, so I'm not gonna, you know, try and return it and crap, and I'm, you know, obviously very excited. It doesn't hurt the readability of the manga, but this is a really cool idea for manga to have this like bar that connects the manga into a visual, and yet you print it off like that, and the person who put the books in the box set went, no, I'm fine with this. This is a great decision. I love how chaotic evil, sir or ma'am, whoever you are, person, you are chaotic. This is chaotic. And I'm very disappointed, but otherwise very excited to read more of Seven Deadly Sins. I started watching the anime. I think it was on Netflix. I don't know if it still is. And I watched the first season and I was really enjoying it. And then I just kind of like lost interest and wasn't really as into it anymore. But I've heard the manga is better than the anime, so I've been wanting to collect it. I have the first two volumes that I've read, but now that the box sets came out, I was like, I'm gonna just switch over to them. And it was, other than that, it's very exciting. Wanted to get that out of the way because it just irks me. Anywho, I also got another volume of Black Butler, volume 9, and it's really hard for me to read Roman numerals, so I'm sorry. But yeah, I only need like a few, like I think volume 2 and then 10 and 11 to fill in like some gaps, and then I'll have like at least the first chunk of Black Butler, you know. As it is a longer series, it's taking me a bit to collect, but this helps. Then I also got Romantic Killer Volume 1. I started watching the anime with my friend when I was visiting her, and it was cute and funny. So yeah, this is a full color too. And then I got a Junji Ito's Cat Diary, Yon and Moo. So it's really cute, just like, I think they're just like short stories involving their cats, like Junji Ito's real cats, and just kind of like how kind of creepy and weird and just absurd cats can be, because like they really can be like little shit sometimes. But I love cats, so I'm really excited for this, and this is like the hardcover collector's edition, so it's very nice, very excited. And then got me volume 3 of Cardcaptor Sakura, the collector's edition as well. Again, I already have the Dark Horse of these, but the collector's hardcover with, you know, just the beautiful cover images. I haven't taken it out of the plastic, so sorry, it's extra glary. But just the beautiful cover images that they like redid for this edition, I just like, I really want them. So I've been, you know, putting them on my birthday list, Christmas list, what have you. Just, you know, don't want to spend the money myself. But I skipped over 2, so I still need 2, but I guess 3 was on sale, so they got me 3, which is fine. It's fine. It's, again, it's not like I am in like, you know, desperate need to read them. Like, I've already read the series, I already own the series, but I just really like these collectors. They're so pretty. So yeah, that's what my parents got me. And then my uncle also got me 1 manga that like he asked my mom for the wish list, and so he got me Tombs by Junji Ito, which is super exciting because I want to get all the Junji Ito I can that is printed and then read them for an October video. So I really am like really trying to get all of them. He has a lot now that they printed in US, so yeah, I'm gonna have a lot to read. But very exciting to have another one of his story collections, even if like my plan to do the video falls through. I just really am a big Junji Ito horror fan, so yeah. And those are all my birthday presents, so now we move on to the presents I bought myself. Okay, so I also acquired a lot of newer manga this month. For some reason, there were so many new releases, or like just releases of series ongoing, that a new volume came out this month. It was overwhelming. But yeah, so I have a lot of newer manga, but I also grabbed some used sale half off manga at my manga store when I was there. So I will share that first. I grabbed His Majesty the Demon King's Housekeeper Volume 1. I don't like cleaning. I'm gonna confess that right now. I am not at all I'm not a dirty person, okay? But my house, my room, like, it's kind of messy, not gonna lie. So this didn't appeal to me on that basis, that I'm just like, is this gonna be all about cleaning? I don't know. But the Demon King is so handsome, I had to just, you know, for half off, check it out, see. I grabbed a random volume of Fire Force because it was half off and I didn't have that volume. I still have so many holes in Fire Force, and I also have so many holes in this series. Blue Exorcist. It just, there was just a random volume 15. I don't have volume 15, so sure. I am not collecting these in order at all. It's insane. And then I also found Beauty and the Feast volume 4. I'd been really collecting this series. Then volume 3, I was kind of like getting less excited about it, so I ended up not ordering volume 4. And then I actually saw the next volume for half off. So I'm like, you know what? I will keep going with it. It's just like, I don't know. Sometimes a series that excites me loses that excitement for me. I'm like, yeah, I could get it, but I don't have to get it. And that's what this one turned into, but it's still like a cute, funny series. And then I actually found a newer release in the half off section, and that was My Secret Affection. I loved the first volume of My Secret Affection. I went to the manga store planning to buy the second volume because I hadn't even realized it had come out or like was scheduled to come out in May, so I didn't pre-order it or anything. And then I found it in the sale for half off, and I was like, yes, of course. Easiest decision of my life. So yeah, I'm super excited to read this. I sadly haven't been reading that many manga this month between vacation, being sick, and then just trying to, you know, upload videos and have my own like work and job I have to do. Just hasn't been as much time, but I'm hoping June I will have more time to be able to read all this wonderful manga I've gotten. And of course, the ones that will come out in June, inevitably. So during May, Kodansha had a sale, so I also grabbed some older series, you know, series that I'm trying to finish collecting or get caught up with. And so I grabbed the rest of the volumes I needed of Sweetness and Lightning, volume 10. And volume 11. I also need volume 12, but it was out of stock. So hopefully they'll send me the last and final volume I need soon, whenever that comes back into stock. But series technically is complete, but like I'm still waiting on the last volume I ordered. So yeah. And then I also grabbed two volumes of Land of the Lustrous. So this is a really cool, interesting concept, like fantasy world type series that I really, really got into. And then I just like, I don't know, like, I don't know if I got caught up at a certain point or something, but like, I haven't ordered the more recent ones. And I think it's up to volume 12, or volume 12 is coming out soon or something, but I only just grabbed 9 and then 10, so it's pretty covers. So yeah, but I still really, really like this series. And then I grabbed a first volume of another series that had come out a little bit ago, and that is PTSD Radio. I immediately saw it and was like, ooh, this seems super up my alley. I am excited about it. And then I saw it was gonna be complete in 3 volumes. So my initial thought was, I'm gonna buy them all together, like all 3 volumes, so that I could read them all together. And then when the sale happened, I like sat on them for a little bit before ordering, and then volume 2 and was out of stock, and I was like, oh, okay. So I ended up just grabbing volume 1, you know, and then eventually I'll get 2 and 3 and then read them all together. It's kind of a bummer, and I almost regret just like getting the first volume, because like I know I'm not gonna read it until I get the second 2, or then like all 3 of them. So it's like, why did I do it? But whatever, it doesn't matter. Eventually I was gonna buy them. So, and then there was like a vertical sale, so I grabbed 2 more volumes of Agent that I need, volume 10 and volume 11. I'm slowly trying to complete this series as well. There's a lot of series that I start and then like they finish, so I'm like, oh good, I can like finally collect them and read them. And then it's like I have so many that, and then the new releases and pre-orders, and then I can only buy so many at a time. So anyway, this one is complete. I think it has 17 volumes, so I'm slowly catching up. I'm slowly on my way to completing this one. Next up, we have new releases of series that I'm already collecting. So they're not volume ones, they're just ongoing series, latest or the latest volume of a series. And I got The King's Beast, volume 10, another adorable cover, so cute. And Usotoki Rhetoric. That first word is so hard for me to say for some reason. Another gorgeous cover. And I got the latest volume of Zom 100. Like, why are all these covers so beautiful? I'm just like, wow, pretty covers. I'm like, each one, I just want to talk about how pretty the cover is. And then an actual, like, the final volume came out of The Saviors Book Cafe, Story in Another World. So this is complete in 5 volumes and so cute. I love this series. It was short and sweet. And then we have the final volume of Miss Miyazen, Would Love to Get Closer to You. Another short, sweet, cute high school romance series, complete at 4 volumes. So yeah, I like short and sweet series. Like, when it comes to romance, I think shorter the better to me. Like, I don't like my romance to drag on usually. Like, usually 15 volumes is my maximum. There are some exceptions, like Fruits Basket and a couple others, but like, usually I like them to be shorter. Just think, you know, if I want a dose of romance and cuteness, a short series like fulfills that for me. But anyway, moving on to My Happy Marriage volume 3, another one I am just in love with. I love this series so much, and oh my god, the covers are beautiful. Then we have the latest volume of Her Royal Highness Seems to Be Angry, volume 5. This one is another reincarnated series. It's just like, she's from the past, same world, but like from way back in the past, and now has been suddenly reincarnated into the present. A lot of hinky things going on. Very interesting. I don't know, I like it. And I got volume 2 of My Special One. So, yeah, I talked about this one and My Secret Affection in a romance volume 1 reads back in like February. So if you're interested to hear more about those two, check that out. I also got volume 3 of Tokyo Aliens, another action shonen type story, but fun read. And I also got the 4th volume of The Most Notorious Talker Runs the World's Greatest Clan. I really like this one. I don't know why. I don't know, it's just an action fantasy series, and it's a fun time. The protagonist is a bit unhinged, but I like my protagonist unhinged, I guess. And then I got a super duper long title. Hi, I'm a Witch and My Crush Wants Me to Make a Love Potion, volume 2. So I really liked volume 1, and this just, I don't know, just one of those super cute fantasy type stories. And I got the 3rd volume of The Other World's Books Depend on the Bee Encounter. A cute, super cute isekai BL. I mean, yeah, I just seriously, like, series. The series is becoming one of my favorite ongoing BLs, we'll just say. And then I got volume 7, the final volume of I Belong to the Baddest Girl at School. And this is just a cute, sweet series as well. You know, a tough kind of delinquent girl has a crush on this kind of quiet and awkward boy who's been used in the past as kind of like gopher, which is like the term used by like an errand boy, someone that just kind of gets used by stronger bully type people. So he thinks they're in that master gopher servant relationship, and she thinks they're like together-ish. So it starts on a very fun miscommunication, and it's just super cute. I enjoyed it. It was a nice ending to a cute series. So no complaints here. Then I got volume 7 of The Dark History of the Reincarnated Villainess. I am obsessed with this series. Like, I know I have a lot of reincarnated villain series that I love. Like, I too many to name right now. But every time a volume comes out, I am not disappointed. I really love this series. I don't know what it is. I'm obsessed with it. I don't know. It's one of those series you just like really love and you don't know why. And then I got volume 5 of Heavenly Delusion. This is a really interesting kind of futuristic dystopian type story. Yeah, I don't know. It's really interesting. And I only read, I think, volume 1 and 2. I have to like kind of go back, I think, and reread it because it's got a lot of going on. And I realized this is one of those series I want to just like read all together and not piecemeal as they come out. So, but I really like the start of it. So excited. And then I got the latest volume, volume 4 of Life Lessons with Uramichi Oni-san. This one's just super funny, and Uramichi is the best character. His dark, sarcastic, witty, depressed self. I relate way too much to this series. It's great. If you're looking for a comedy series, if you have a kind of, I don't know, like a darker, humoristic look at life, like, you know, if you look at the glass as half empty type mentality, this is a series for you. So funny. Next up, we have a new volume 1, but I also got volume 1 and volume 2. I think volume 1 came when I was away on vacation. And then volume 2 came out this month, which really close together. Like, it's insane. But anyway, I got the continuation of Shaman King, which is Shaman King Flowers, volume 1 and volume 2. So yeah, I still really want to go and read all of Shaman King. But they, you know, coming out with this, so I'm like, well, all right, I'll just keep collecting it and I'll have even more Shaman King to read when I get to it. Just overwhelm myself with Shaman King. That sounds great. And I also got volume 2 of Megumi and Tsugumi. I don't love Omega type BL stories, but I really do enjoy this one. It's comedic and it's cute and heartwarming at times, and it's definitely spicy. And yeah, it's a pretty good read. Okay, so then we got some standalone BL titles. I got Tsumasaki in Korozu. I think that's maybe how you say it. Anyway, I don't know. This is like a slice of life. It says shonen eye, so I'm guessing maybe not any spicy scenes, but I don't know. I haven't read it yet. Like I said, I haven't read a lot. And then I got Cut Over Criteria, which, I don't know, seemed like cute, like, office co-workers get closer. I don't know why I always love a good office romance, so yeah. And then lastly, I got A Complicated Omega's Second Love. Again, I'm afraid. I'm always a little nervous when it comes to Omega verse type stories, but it was a one shot, so it's easier for me to like try and check it out, see if I like it. And then we got some first volume BL. Might as well just keep going with the BL. I got My Dear Agent volume 1, which, I mean, that cover looking so handsome. Definitely cover by. I got Manner of Death volume 1, which I got because, I mean, I absolutely really enjoyed the Thai BL Manner of Death. I flipped through it just kind of curious, like how the characters looked and interacted and stuff, and it definitely didn't seem like the same as the Thai BL, so I think I'll be able to enjoy it independently from the Thai drama. So yeah, but this is a nice like murder mystery type BL. Then I got Happy Crappy Life volume 1. So I did, in all honesty, read a chunk of this series online. I really liked Harada's other work, so I wanted to check it out. I was not super in love with this one. So you're like, well, Zoe, why did you buy it then? hopefully to be pleasantly surprised upon rereading it, maybe? My issue wasn't with the main protagonist, it was with, I forget which one it was. I think it was him, but like a bully of his or something from the past who now like wants to get with him. I found him so unnecessary and irritating. I just hope that, like, I don't know, I can ignore that bit and just like enjoy the two main characters. Hopefully he kind of gets phased out as the series goes on and our protagonists maybe actually get closer and have more of a relationship, because they're kind of just like F buddies for now. Anyway, like up until what I read anyway. And next we have one that I absolutely love that I read online, and that was Twilight Out of Focus. I loved this volume. I really thought it was a standalone volume and I ended up buying it in Japanese. But it is, I guess there was like there's gonna be two more at least. I saw the pre-orders up for volume 2 and volume 3. But I think it follows not just this couple, but like other characters. So I'm very excited because I only read this volume. So those will be exciting and different and something I haven't read before. But I absolutely loved this volume. Like these boys are, the story, it was really good. I enjoyed it a lot. It's just cute, like roommates who, you know, become closer than just roommates. So adorable. And last of the BL titles, I got Ogi's Summer Break. It sounded really, really adorable when I read the premise, and I don't know. So yeah, I'm excited. Before we move on entirely from all things BL, I got to Don May as well. So I got the first volume of Remnants of Filth. Honestly, can't even say what this is about. I just saw another Don May title, and I think there were so many, and I was reading like all the synopsises, so they kind of like all meshed together. But I think this is the one about two like generals that were friends, and then one like switches sides, I believe. Yeah, I don't know, but I don't care. Like, I will pick up all of them. I have no standards. I don't know. What the heck? And then the last volume of Grandmaster of Demonic Cultivation, which, oh, I love it. I need to read all of it. I did start reading it and then I was like, no, I want to wait until they're all out and read it all together. And now they're all out and I have no excuse and I need to read it. But of course I got the special edition, and that came with cute things like this bookmark and these adorable little chibi stickers and the postcards from all the covers, which I didn't love the cover art of this one as much as other ones, but I have to say the final cover was giving. And then it also has some posters with it and this cute little like journal book, which was a pleasant surprise. I don't know, pretty. So yeah. Alrighty, and then the last of the manga are some more volume ones, and I'll just start with the two that I did manage to read. yeah, I'm judging me too on the lack of manga I read this month, so yeah, feel free. So I read Me and My Beast Boss. So I have a thing where like I like beast aspects, like the ears and tail or what have you. Like, I'm a wolf, but my boss is a sheep. Adorable. Love it. This one, I could tell, you know, obviously by like the synopsis and stuff and picture on the back. He's a full ass animal lion kind of creature that, you know, obviously can walk on 2 feet, but much more animalistic. So I didn't know how to feel about that, but the art just drew me in. Like, the art is so pretty. Like, when I flipped through it, like, I couldn't help myself. I had to get it and check it out, and I really, really liked it. I did. I'm like, oh, it's so cute. Like, he's really like a kind, interesting character, and she's like a hardworking, like very sincere character, and I like them. I like them together too, which is conflicting. Ah, so anyway, I really did like volume one, and I will get volume two, and we'll see what happens. And then the other volume one I read, I just found, I think someone posted about it on Instagram. I see a lot of things, a lot of manga, and like, I don't even know where like half of the ones I see come from. But anyway, I think it was Instagram, and it looked really good, and it wasn't on Rightstep. I could only find it on Amazon. So I got it off there, and that was Disobey the Duke, If You Dare. Oh. It was really good. Oh shit. The books just fell over on me, you know, as they do when you stack them up like that. Oh god. Okay, so this one, look at the cover. Like, look at the sparkly, like opalescent, like pearlescent, whatever you call that. Oh, it's just so pretty. I was like, the art too, oh my god, like the art is so pretty. There was like literal panels where I just stopped and was like, I'm just gonna enjoy this. Like, right there, very pretty, and he's of course very pretty, they're really cute together. Even though he doesn't want her to look at him, that's like part of the marriage arrangement, because he is the product of some kind of human beast hybrid thing. I don't know, but look at him, he's so cute. Anyway, I'm like rambling about this one bit. I just really enjoyed it. Was it perfect? No. I mean, there, it's obviously has some of the same kind of cliched things that a lot of these webtoon type stories have. And this story, twice I think, it like kind of jumped in. I don't know, its pacing was a bit weird that I noticed, but I don't care. I have my blinders on and I'm just enjoying the stupid fun ride. So if you like stupid fun romance like this, then I think you'd enjoy it, because it's so pretty. And it was really fun to read. I can't wait for volume two. And yeah, it's by like Manta Comics, which is like a app you can get and like read webtoons online. So they printed an actual physical copy, which is very exciting, and I kind of hope they do more of that, if hopefully this one sells well and they'll release more. I'm getting so sucked into the webtoons. Okay, and then the last four we'll start, that I haven't read yet, first volumes came out, is We Can't Do Just Plain Love volume one. So yeah, this one seems a bit spicy, a bit saucy too, so I'm really excited about this one. This was one of the ones that came while I was away, and then like because like I got home from vacation, was sick, like had to go back to work, like I was really run down for a while, I just like literally forgot about it. I was like going through my manga to like do this haul and was like, oh my god, I forgot about this one. But yeah, excited to read it, you know, when I do read. Now that I've remembered, I have it, but yeah. And then I got Welcome to Demon School, Iruma-kun, and this one just looks like it's gonna be like a fun, comedic kind of fantasy story. So yeah, I'm excited. And then I got Wolf Girl in Black Prince. I did watch the anime that came out, but I'm very excited to check out the manga now that it's in English. And yeah, it's just about like a very princely guy, very popular, but the girl sees his rotten kind of personality. Neither of them are morally perfect people, which I love. I love me some flawed romantic couple pairings. And then lastly, I got Last Game. So this is another romantic styles one where it gives me, like when I read the synopsis, very much the feel of SA or Special Academy, where like there's a rivalry going on between a guy and a girl, but in Special A, the rivalry was that she could never win against him, and this is kind of a reversal of that, where he's the top dog, and then she transfers into school and ends up beating him and everything, and he gets kind of like taken down a peg, and so starts their rivalry. So yeah, that was my May haul. Of course, I had a bit more because of it being my birthday and some presents I got, which is super awesome. And I just got, there was a lot of new releases in May too. And it looks like a lot of manga releases in the coming months as well. And I'm just like feeling overwhelmed because too many. I can't get them all. But gosh darn it, I want to. It's always been my problem, is like if I see it and it looks interesting, then I want to get it. Not good. Don't be like me. But yeah, I'm very excited for the manga I did get to read this month, and of course for all the manga I still need to read. And with that being said, if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. And I was in such a weird mood. Like, I don't know if I'm like tired. I went for a walk and like the sun was so hot. I feel like it just like sucked out all my energy. So I'm sorry about that. If I like, I just felt like I wasn't as high energy as usual, but like happens. I hope you didn't mind. And yeah, until next time, bye.